ଜୟ ଅନିଲ ପ୍ରେମ ଧନ କରୁଣା ପ୍ରଚୁର ଜୟ ଅନିଲ ପ୍ରେମ ଧନ କରୁଣା ପ୍ରଚୁର ହେନ ପ୍ରଭୁ କୋଥା ଗେଲା ଆଚାର୍ଯ୍ୟ ଠାକୁର प्रभु कोता गेला आचार्य ठाकुर हे न प्रभु कोता गेला आचार्य ठाकुर गेला आचार्य ठाकुर कहाँ मोरा स्वरूप रूपा कहाँ सनातना मोरा स्वरूप रूपा कहाँ सनातना कहाँ मोरा स्वरूप रूपा कहाँ सनातना कहाँ दास रघुनाथ पतित पावन दास रघुनाथ पतित पावन कहाँ दास रघुनाथ पतित पावन दश रघुनाथ पतित पावन कहाँ मोरा भट्ट जुग कहाँ कविराज मोरा भट्ट युग कहाँ कविराज कहाँ मोरा भट्ट युग कहाँ कविराज भट्ट युग कहाँ कविराज एक काले कोठा गेला पूरा नटराज 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 पाषाण कूटी बो माठा अनल पाशीबो पाषाण कूटी बो माठा अनल पाशीबो पाषाण कूटी बो माठा अनल पाशीबो ibo mata anale pashi do gauranga gunera nidhi kothagele pabo gauranga gunera nidhi kothagele pabo गौरंग गुणे निधि পাবো রঙ গুণে রানি রে সব সঙ্গীরা সঙ্গে যে কইল বিলাস সব সঙ্গীরা সঙ্গে যে কইল বিলাস সে সব সঙ্গীরা সঙ্গে যে কইল বিলাস সঙ্গীরা সঙ্গে কইল বিলাস সে সঙ্গ না পাইয়া কান্দে নরোত্তম দাস সঙ্গ না পাইয়া কান্দে নরোত্তম দাস সঙ্গনা পাইয়া কান্দে নরোত্তম দাস সঙ্গনা পাইয়া কান্দে নরোত্তম দাস জয় বৈষ্ণব ঠাকুর জয় বৈষ্ণব ঠাকুর জয় বৈষ্ণব ঠাকুর জয় বৈষ্ণব ঠাকুর জয় প্রভু পদা জয় প্রভু পদা জয় প্রভু পদা জয় প্রভু পদা ভক্তবৃন্দা হরে কৃষ্ণ 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 হরে 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 রাম 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 হরে হরে টুডে ইজ দি ডিসঅপিয়ারেন্স ডে অফ শ্রীলা গৌরকিশোরদাস বাবাজি মহারাজ আই উইল স্পিক এ লিটল অবাউট দ্য great Vaishnava Acharya Srila Gaurkishwardas Babaji Maharaj. Srila Gaurkishwardas Babaji Maharaj is the spiritual master of Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur is the spiritual master of His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. So there is a prayer that concisely describes the personality of Srila Gaurkishwardas Babaji Maharaj. I shall recite this prayer and the meaning is also going to follow. Namo Gaurakishoraya Sakshad Vairagya Murtaye Vipralambha Rasambhode Padambhujayate Namaha. The meaning of this prayer: I offer my respectful obeisances unto Gaurkishwardas Babaji Maharaj, the spiritual master of Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, who is renunciation personified, Sakshat Vairagya Murtaye. He is always merged in a feeling of separation and intense love of Krishna. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu teaches us that rendering devotional service to Krishna in separation from Krishna is the highest type of devotional service to Krishna. And this was best exemplified by the gopis of Vrindavan. When Krishna left Vrindavan, the gopis were heartbroken. And even though Krishna said he's going to return in just 2-3 days, he never returned to Vrindavan after leaving Vrindavan to Mathura and later to Dwaraka. So the gopis, they were crying and crying and crying in separation from Krishna. Normally, in the material world, if somebody is attached to a particular person, then in separation, they may feel that I am missing. But how long will that feeling of missing the person who is absent will be there? Whereas the gopis, their feeling of separation from Krishna intensified as time passed by and Krishna did not return. And rest of their life, they were just crying for Krishna. So this is called Vipralambha. So Srila Gaurakishore Das Babaji Maharaj is always merged in a feeling of separation and intense love of Krishna. And as his biographers describe, he was very, very, very renowned. And one particular description given by Srila Prabhupada, there is a practical example set for us by Srila Gaurakishore Das Babaji Maharaj, who used to sit on the side of a latrine to chant Hare Krishna. Many materialistic persons used to come and bother him and disturb his daily routine of chanting. So, to avoid their company, he used to sit by the side of a latrine where materialistic persons would not go because of the filth and the obnoxious smell. However, Gaurakishore Das Babaji Maharaj was so great that he was accepted as the spiritual master of such a great personality as His Divine Grace, Om Vishnupad, Sri Srimad, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Maharaj. So, why would Srila Gaurakishore Das Babaji Maharaj sit in such a filthy place? Now, we should understand, internally, he is completely detached from the external surroundings. When he is absorbed in his devotional service of chanting and hearing the Hare Krishna mantra. Of course, pure devotee's chanting is on the liberated platform. Nevertheless, they are not externally making a show of devotion. They are very much in this world in the sense that they also experience the external conditions as far as their body is concerned, but their heart, their consciousness is absorbed differently, not in the body, not in the mind, but in Krishna consciousness. So, some brief biographical account of this great Vaishnava, by whose blessings we can very quickly make advancement in Krishna consciousness by receiving the blessings of such great acharyas, especially on this auspicious day of his divine disappearance. Disappearance means he passed on, he passed away from this world. He returned to Krishna's personal abode on this day in 1915. It is November 16, 1915, when he passed away. So the biographical account is described. Srila Gaurakishore Das Babaji Maharaj appeared sometime in the 1830s in the village of Wagyan in East Bengal or Bangladesh. He was born as the son of a Vaishya by name Vamshi Das. During his boyhood, his mother and father arranged a marriage for him and he remained in household life for about 20 years. While a householder, he worked as a broker in grain business. But even at that time, he exhibited his spirituality. After the demise of his wife, Srila Gaur Kishordas Babaji Maharaj left his business and went to Vrindavan. How is it that he just left and went to Vrindavan? Because he was exhibiting his spiritual interest, deep spiritual interest, even as a householder. And when he reached Vrindavan, he approached one of the foremost disciples of Srila Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj by name Srila Bhagavad Das Babaji Maharaj. And from Bhagavad Das Babaji Maharaj, he accepted the traditional Paramahamsa Vaishnava Babaji Vesha. That is accepting the renounced order as a Babaji. After this, he became completely renounced and stayed in Vrindavan under various trees in different parts of the 168-mile Vraja Mandala or the circle of Vrindavan. He continuously was performing devotional service in this way for another 30 years. During this time, he associated with great exalted pure devotees like Srila Swarup Das Babaji Maharaj at Jagannath Puri, Sri Bhagwan Das Babaji at Kalna, and Srila Chaitanya Das Babaji at Kulia. These are all holy places connected with Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's pastimes. And all these personalities are great exalted devotees. So he was always performing his own devotional service and also taking association of exalted devotees. Then in Vrindavan, Srila Gaur Kishordas Babaji Maharaj became very famous among the devotees and was awarded the appropriate title of Bhajanandi. Bhajanandi means there are two kinds of devotees who are seriously engaged in devotional service. One is called Bhajanandi, means one who's completely dedicated for practicing one's own devotional service and associating with others who are similarly practicing and not really so much traveling or not so much of externally preaching the message of Krishna consciousness. And the Goshtyanandi, the second category of devotees, are those who, even though they are very, very exalted devotees, they come down to the platform of the common people and try to preach Krishna consciousness and spread the message of Krishna consciousness among ordinary people, those who are forgetful of Krishna, those who are absorbed materially, in order to redeem them, in order to deliver them, in order to enlighten them, in order to pull them out of Maya. Now, it may seem like Goshtyanandis are very compassionate, are very kind, are very much inclined to do welfare activity for others. But that is not true, that only Goshtyanandis are doing welfare activity for others. Even the Bhajanandis are engaged similarly. That will be evident from the life of the great devotees like Gaur Kishordas Babaji Maharaj. The Bhajanandis, they sit in one place and they chant, but their chanting is so powerful, it purifies the sinful atmosphere of this material world. So that is the power of their chanting. And whoever approaches them, just by getting even a particle of dust of the lotus feet, one can get immense spiritual benedictions from such exalted devotees. Not only that, they do speak to people who approach them and try to get some spiritual instructions, spiritual guidance. Now, even though Srila Gaurakishordas Babaji Maharaj received lot of honor from many, many, many devotees, he was never interested in material sense gratification. He was not interested in enjoying that name and fame and honor and respect from others. He totally disapproved of the secret material desires of pseudo-renunciate. He would perform his pure devotional pastimes alone in a profound devotional mood. Now, after staying about 30 years in Vrindavan, he traveled to Navadvip from Vrindavan under the instruction of Srila Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj, his guru's guru, in the year 1897. He was about 60 years old at that time. And from that time until his disappearance in 1915, say about 28 years, he lived in Navadvip Dham in different places, which were the different places of pastimes of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And he was trying to realize the non-difference between the holy places in Navadvip and those in Vrindavan. Now, regarding his renunciation, it is said, he begged by gathering dry foodstuff from the householders of the holy dham. In order to cook, he would collect dry wood from the roadside and earthen pots discarded by the villagers on the banks of rivers. He would sometimes offer the foodstuff to the Supreme Lord by simply holding some foodstuff in his hand. In order to clothe himself, he would go to the shore of the river Ganga and collect and wash discarded cloth that had been used to cover dead bodies being burnt at the ghat. Thus, he always remained independent of support of others simply by utilizing items of no value to others and living a very, very simple life. In 1897, Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur constructed an ashram called Swananda Sukhada Kunja in Navadvip Dham, in a place called Godrumadvipa, by the bank of the river Saraswati, which flows in that area. Here, Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur would stay and recite and explain the Srimad Bhagavatam to all those who would come to hear Srimad Bhagavatam from the exalted Acharya. Now, Srila Gaurakishordas Babaji Maharaj would regularly come to Swananda Sukhada Kunja and hear the talks of Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur with great delight. Now, what were the possessions of Gaurakishordas Babaji Maharaj? It is described. His only possessions were the tulsi beads he wore around his neck and the tulsi japamala he kept in his hand for chanting his japa and counting his rounds. He also kept particularly two books, Srila Narottam Das Thakur's collection of devotional songs called Prarthana and Prema Bhakti Chandrika. Even though it seemed like Srila Gaurakishordas Babaji Maharaj was not a learned Sanskrit scholar, nor was he able to read. He was not formally educated. But still, the purport and conclusions of all the scriptures were luminous in his heart and his character. It was never possible for anyone to to render any service to Srila Gaur Kishoradas Babaji Maharaj. Because he was never willing to accept service from others. His attitude was always he regarded everyone else as his master, Prabhu. I am the servant of every other person. So I will never accept service, but I'll only give service. Now Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu teaches us that the ideal character of a Vaishnava is that Amanina manadena kirtaniya sadaharihi. So Srila Gaur Kishoradas Babaji Maharaj exemplified the ideal Vaishnava character. How did he do that? Kirtaniya sadaharihi, always engaged in chanting Hare Krishna. And Amanina, Amanina means he will never accept any respect from others, any honor from others, any service from others. And manadena means he will always offer respect from his side to every other person. Due respects he will offer. Very, very humble. Very humble. And this is natural for a pure devotee of Krishna. So, Gaur Kishoradas Babaji Maharaj was a pure devotee of Krishna. Now, there are several instances of Srila Gaur Kishoradas Babaji Maharaj instructing people who approached him and enlightening them in case they were seeking genuine spiritual guidance or if they had an ulterior motive. Srila Gaur Kishoradas Babaji Maharaj would expose the ulterior motives of materialists who wanted to make an external show of devotion, but internally they were only interested in material sense enjoyment. There are several incidents mentioned in this biography, few of which I will try to mention here. Once a householder Vaishnava presented a valuable shawl to Srila Gaur Kishoradas Babaji Maharaj. Now, Srila Gaur Kishoradas Babaji Maharaj accepted it and kept it with great care and highly praised this gift. On another occasion, another Vaishnava family gave Srila Gaur Kishoradas Babaji Maharaj a few rupees as a donation. Now, this donation also, Srila Gaur Kishoradas Babaji Maharaj accepted very nicely and tied it very carefully to the border of his outer garment and kept it extremely carefully. Now he was examining with his hand repeatedly whether the money he has kept is safe and is secure. A wealthy materialistic person came from Calcutta to Navadvip and noticed this. This Babaji is supposed to be very renounced, but always he is checking whether the money is safe and he's very carefully kept an expensive shawl. So he thought, what kind of a renunciant is this Babaji? So whatever little faith this wealthy materialist had, he actually lost that faith. Oh, this is not a genuine renunciate. A few days later, Babaji Maharaj gave away the shawl and the money to another Vaishnava. Now, when this wealthy materialist went back to Calcutta, met Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, he remarked, I went to see that Babaji Maharaj in Navadvip. But I saw that he was eagerly receiving a shawl and some money, and he was securely keeping the money, and he was glorifying the donors. So I thought, what kind of a sadhu is he? But then hearing this foolish remark from that wealthy materialist, Saraswati Thakur replied, you have merely observed his superficial behavior. In reality, he has shown his attachment to the service of Krishna. The rest of us show our attachment to worldly pleasures. The fools for whom the wealth is very dear, they think Babaji Maharaj is also greedy for some wealth. But actually, Babaji Maharaj was not really interested in that wealth or the shop. He was praising a person who was serving a Vaishnava. Whereas we materialistic persons, we tend to praise somebody who will give us sense gratification. See the contrast. As materialistic persons look upon this world as enjoyable, a devotee of Krishna looks in this world towards using everything in Krishna's service. In this way, a true devotee, even though personally he is fully renounced, whatever is required for Krishna's service, he very carefully keeps them and utilizes them for Krishna. See, what did Babaji Maharaj do with what he had received? Why was he keeping it carefully? In order to utilize that for serving another Vaishnava. Not for his own personal purpose. Then there is another instance of unconditional shelter at the lotus feet of a bona fide spiritual master. There is an instance that under the instruction of Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur's son, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, went to meet Srila Gaur Kishoras Babaji Maharaj. Now Bhakti Vinod Thakur instructed his son, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, that you go and take Diksha, Vaishnava Diksha, from Srila Gaur Kishoras Babaji Maharaj. When Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati approached his own father that I want Diksha from you. So Bhakti Vinod Thakur directed Bhakti Siddhanta to approach Srila Gaur Kishoras Babaji Maharaj. So accordingly, Siddhanta Saraswati went to Gaur Kishoras Babaji Maharaj and requested, prayed, begged from him, I want Diksha from you. On that occasion, the first attempt that Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur approached Gaur Kishoras Babaji Maharaj and asked for initiation, the first instance, Babaji Maharaj replied, I shall ask Mahaprabhu about this, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. For without asking him, I cannot give you a reply. So on the next day, Srila Saraswati Thakur approached him again and he inquired whether Babaji Maharaj had received any reply from Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So Babaji Maharaj said he had forgotten to ask Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So then Saraswati Thakur earnestly implored Babaji Maharaj, saying, if I do not get your mercy, I shall not maintain my life. So he said this and went away. And on the third day, when Saraswati Thakur approached himself, approached again Babaji Maharaj, Babaji Maharaj said that I inquired from Mahaprabhu, but Mahaprabhu said, good behavior and scholarship are extremely insignificant in comparison to devotional service to the Supreme Lord. Hearing this, Saraswati Thakur was very hurt and said that If I do not receive the mercy of your divine lotus feet, I shall give up my life. Goshtipurna favored Sri Ramanujacharya after his request for initiation was turned down 18 times. Ramanujacharya, the previous Acharya, he approached his guru 18 times begging for initiation. He would not give up. So he was favored only after the 18th time. So Saraswati Thakur told Babaji Maharaj, certainly I shall wait to be favored by you someday. This is my firm vow. I shall never give up. Waiting and waiting and waiting till you give me this. Hearing this, Babaji Maharaj was very, very pleased and sprinkled him with the dust of his lotus feet. That same day, Srila Gaur Keshavdas Babaji Maharaj initiated Saraswati Thakur at Swananda Sukhada Kunja. So, this is the eagerness to receive the blessings, the diksha, the guidance, the dust of the lotus feet of the exalted pure devotee. It's not a cheap thing that you simply go and ask and they give it. No. In fact, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur was the only disciple of Srila Gaur Kishoras Babaji Maharaj. Because nobody else could actually pass the test that Srila Gaur Kishoras Babaji Maharaj would give to anybody approaching him to seek shelter at his lotus feet. Another instance about difference between love and lust, prema and kama. So it is described, a learned caste Goswami delivered a discourse on the Srimad Bhagavatam, a section of the Bhagavatam describing Bhramara Gita. This is one section in the Bhagavatam where Radharani, when she separated from Krishna after Krishna left Vrindavan and went away to Mathura and Dwarka, so Krishna sent a messenger, Uddhava, to pacify the gopis and Radharani who were feeling separation. So that conversation which Radharani had in the presence of Uddhava with a bumblebee, Bhramara, it's called Bhramara Gita, that is very famous in the Srimad Bhagavatam. So a learned caste Goswami was delivering discourse on this Bhramara Gita at Kuliya in Navadvip. After he had lectured for 2 or 3 days, someone informed Gaur Kishoras Babaji Maharaj that this learned caste Goswami's discourses are excellent. And nobody before him has ever expounded on these topics so very eloquently. So hearing this, Babaji Maharaj told, don't go to hear that discourse on Bhramara Gita again. Why? When there is rain, weeds grow very quickly. Carefully planted seeds also can grow. But some are prematurely destroyed by a heavy downpour. By hearing a discourse about Krishna and his pastimes, the seeds of love for Krishna will certainly sprout in the heart of those persons who are pure and devoid of material desires and sincerely dedicated to the service of Guru and Vaishnava. Now, in somebody's heart, if the seed of lust is there, then immediately, upon hearing such topics, their lusty propensity will increase. Why? Because they can't understand the transcendental nature of the exchange of love between Radha and Krishna, specifically described in the 10th canto of the Bhagavatam in this section. The conditioned soul is covered by lust. And what can they understand? Till they are purified in their heart, what can they understand about the love affairs of Radha and Krishna, which are completely spiritual, have got nothing to do with any material exchanges in this world? So, Babaji Maharaj is telling that those who assume that because they have little inclination to hear about Radha Krishna's pastime, before they have purified their heart, they are not aware how their own lusty desires will overwhelm them because they are still under the influence of Maya. And they cannot understand the transcendental nature of these descriptions in the Srimad Bhagavatam of the exchanges of love between Radha and Krishna. So, hearing this, another man in the assembly, who was in the assembly, he told Babaji Maharaj, I saw that some people in the audience were listening to the Brahmari Gita and they were crying in spiritual ecstasy, saying, oh Radha, oh Krishna. Babaji Maharaj replied, it was not any spiritual ecstasy. It was simply their madness born out of their lusty desire. This kind of deviation will ruin the whole world. You have come to know of their so-called ecstasy by seeing them weep. But you don't understand that that person has no love for Krishna at all. How can anybody have love for Krishna when they are victim of display of Maya? If someone has truly achieved love of God, then request him to leave his home and family. He should come to the bank of the Ganga and he should renounce sense gratification and take shelter honestly of non-duplicitous bhajana. So, if we observe him performing this austerity, then we will know the true extent of his eagerness to hear such exalted topics as Brahmari Gita from the Bhagavatam.